We are looking at a mathematics 12th class sample paper of board. This is section D. Each question carries 6 marks. The first one is, there are two options. First one is this integration, other one is also integration. So let us see the first one. We know that x by 1 plus sin x, and if this is the integral, we can use, if this is x, we can use this integral as pi minus x. So we can substitute pi minus x. So we are substituting pi minus x here, and we know that pi minus x is nothing but sin pi minus x is what? Sin x. It doesn't matter. Now we'll take this pi by 1 plus sin x and this one, these two separately, and in this one pi will come outside the integral. We can take this constant, and this is x by 1 plus sin x. See, this was I, this is again I, same stuff. So we can write it as I, and we can transfer it on the left hand side. So this I plus I becomes 2i. Now 2i is equal to pi 1 by 1 plus sin x. Now we have to solve this. 1 plus sin x, for sin x we can write cos pi by 2 minus x, because cos pi by 2 minus x is nothing but sin x. But we know that 1 plus cos theta is equal to 2 cos square theta by 2. We will replace this here, 2 cos square theta by 2, and this 2 we can take out, means pi by 4, and this cos square we can take up, so this will be sec square, and now we will integrate. And when we integrate, we will put the limits as pi first and then minus that of 0, and this will be the result. The second is sin x by sin cube x plus cos cube x. First thing is, we will divide the numerator and denominator by this cos cube x. Cos cube x. Here also cos cube x. Now, this becomes tan cube x, this becomes 1, and this sin by cos cube x is cos x cos square x. This is tan, and this will be, it will go up, so sec square x. This will be the result after dividing the numerator and denominator by cos cube x. Now here we will put tan x equal to t. So dt will be sec square x dx. So this becomes t by t cube plus 1. Now t cube plus 1 is nothing but t plus 1, t square minus t plus 1. So this we know the formula, a cube plus b cube, a plus b a square minus b, b minus plus b square minus ab, right? Now what we will do here is, this t can be written as t plus 1 minus 1. This one we will take with this one, and minus we will take here. So what we are taking here is minus this 1 by 3, and then 1 by t plus 1 dt, and this again t plus 1 t square minus t plus 1, right? Now we just have to do this. This is log t plus 1, we are left with this. So this t plus, this 2t minus 1 plus 3 is what? 2t plus 2, that is 2t plus 1. So t plus 1 can be written as this one. But since there is 2, we have to divide this by 2, so this becomes 6. Now let us separate it, this one and this one. This is nothing but, if you take this as t, this will be dt. So this will be log, and this will be written in the form of x square plus a square. So you know how to make it as x square plus a square, and this will be nothing but tan inverse 2t minus 1 by root 3. So this is the solution. Two option again, does the following trigonometric equation have any solution? If yes, obtain the solution. Then the next one is, determine whether this star defined below on Q is a binary operation or not. If yes, check for commutative and associative properties. Also check the existence of identity element and the inverse of all the elements in Q. First is tan inverse x plus 1 by x minus 1 plus tan inverse x minus 1 by x. This is equal to tan inverse 7. So we'll use the formula of tan inverse a plus tan inverse b. This will be equal to tan inverse A plus B by 1 minus AB. So, tan inverse A plus B, 1 minus AB. And we know that this will always be less than 1. This will always be less than 1. We don't want it to be 0. So, this is equal to minus tan inverse 7. After this, we will take this tan inverse from here to here. So, this becomes 10. Tan inverse cancel, you will get minus 7. When we solve this, you get 2x square minus x plus 1 by minus x plus 1. And now you have to solve this quadratic equation. If you multiply here and rearrange it, the x will be 2. And let us verify whether this x equal to 2 does satisfy the equation or not. Let us see whether it is satisfying it, is it not, because it should be, the content here should be less than 1. So the content was this. This should be less than 1 and 3 by 2, which is not less than 1. So this does not satisfy the condition. So there is no solution to the given trigonometric equation. The second part is we have to see this star on Q, which is defined by A star B is nothing but AB plus 1. So wherever we find these two values, we'll do multiplication of these two plus 1. Since A belongs to this Q, you know this set, B belongs to this Q, then A into B will also belong to Q, and if you add plus 1, this will also belong to Q. That means this is defined on Q. So this is a binary operation. First thing is complete. Now commutative. Commutative means if A cross B is AB plus 1, B cross A is what? We'll write B here, A here plus 1, exactly like this. And then we can just commute it, because multiplication is commutative on Q. So AB plus 1. So A star B is B star A, that is star is commutative on Q. Next is associative. So AB star C can be written as AB plus 1 star C. Now this is A, this is B. So we'll multiply these two plus 1. And now just rearrange it, means multiply and rearrange or write like this, ABC plus C plus 1. Now let us see this one. BC is there, so BC plus 1. And now this is A, this is B, so A into B plus 1. Now just open it, you get ABC plus A plus 1, which is not equal to this. These two are not equal. So the star is not associative on Q. Identity element. Let us assume E belong to Q. This is the identity element. For every A which belongs to Q, A into E is A and E into A is A. So let us see A into E is what? A, E by this operation, which is given to us, plus 1, which is equal to A, and E, A plus 1 equal to A. So what is E? A minus 1 by A. What is E here? A minus 1 by A. So E is not unique because it depends on A. This value of A decides the value of E. It is not unique. So there is no identity element for star. And since there is no identity element, we will not talk for the inverse. There is no inverse. We have to find the value of x, y, z if A is this, and we satisfy A transpose is equal to A inverse. The second part is, second option is also there. We'll see it in a bit. So A transpose is A inverse. That means if you multiply A both side, that is A transpose of A is this is what? A inverse of A is I. So let us take this value and take the transpose of this. So we are converting the row into column, row into column, row into column, and this is equal to identity. So 1 1 1, the diagonal matrix is, the diagonal value is, will be 1 1 1, others will be 0. Let us multiply it. You know how to multiply this and equate it to this value. So this becomes 2x square 6y square 3z square, and this 2x square becomes equal to 1, 6y square becomes equal to 1, and 3z square equal to 1. When you equate them, x will be plus minus 1 by root 2, y will be plus minus 1 by root 6, and z will be plus minus 1 by root 3. The second is this A. Let me take you to the question first. The question is this. A of adjoint A, and I presume that you know how to compute the adjoint A, right? Then which is nothing but the you have to find the determinant first, and then you have to divide it with the inverse. So adjoint A into adjoint A, adjoint A into A is mod of A into I. This is A. Now let us solve it. A is nothing but this, so we will have to find the mod, that is the value. So value can be found out. The mod A into I, let us multiply this with 11. So 11, 11, 11. Adjoint A is this. A into adjoint A is what? Multiply these two, you get this. These two are similar. Let us find adjoint A into A. When we multiply this, this is also similar to this. So it is verified that these three are equal. This one, and this one. Find dy by dx if y is equal to e sin square x and 2 tan inverse 1 minus x by 1 plus x. So we need to solve this first under root. For that, let us put x equal to cos 2 theta. So this is 1 minus cos 2 theta by 1 plus cos 2 theta. And we know that 1 minus cos theta is nothing but 2 sin square theta by 2. And 1 plus cos 2 theta is 2 sin square theta by 2. 2 gets cancelled. This becomes 10 square theta. 10 square theta. 10 and 10 inverse cancels. This will be 2 tan inverse 10 theta. 10 inverse cancels. 2 theta. Theta is cos 2 theta. Right. So what is theta? Cos inverse x by 2. Cos inverse x by 2. So this 2 gets cancelled. It will be only cos inverse x. For this, we can write y e sin square x, and this is cos inverse x. Now let us take log on both the sides. Log y will be equal to sin square y will come here, and this will be log cos inverse x. Log y is 1 by y dy by dx. This is 2 sin x cos x. This will be 1 by cos inverse x, and cos inverse x will be minus 1 by 1 minus x square. 2 sin x cos x is sin 2x, and this is nothing but cos inverse 1 by under root 1 minus x square. This is your dy by dx. Find the shortest between this line and the curve. So you have a curve and your line. See, this is what y square is equal to 4ax. So this is a kind of this figure. You know what this figure is known. Conic sections we have learned, and this is the line. So you have to find out the distance between these two. So let if you take some point here, say if you take x as t, y will say y as t, and x will be t square. So t square and t, you can take the point. This is on this curve. So the distance of this point from this line will be nothing but, we are putting t here, t square here, because this y, you assume this y is t square actually. T square and this is t. So t square you are putting at the place of y, x is t minus 1 by under root 1 plus 1. That is under root 1 square plus 1 square. And this is going to be this value. And we know that if you find out the, if you can make it as a perfect square, this is always greater than 0. So this is the equation. Now, let us, this is the S. So ds by dt, let us take 1 by, we are taking the root, the derivative of this, which is equal to d, and which is equal to this value. Now, d2s by dt square is what? You can take the differential of this. This is getting to be root 2, which is greater than 0. And ds by dt, if you put 0, this as 0, you get the value of t as half. So s is half, or s is minimum at t equal to half. And what is the value? T square minus t plus 1, place in the previous formula, you get 3 root 2 by 8. Define skew lines. Using only vector approach, find the shortest distance between following two skew lines. So if these two are lines, these skew lines are nothing but, when you have a 3D view, so two lines may not be parallel and they will not even intersect. So the line which are not neither intersecting or nor parallel, these are known as skew lines. So the equations are like this. What will be A1? This one, A1. What will be A2? A2 will be this one. What will be your B1? This will be B1. And this will be your B2. Even A2, B1, B2 you got. Now, A2 minus A1 is what? We know this formula, okay? The shortest distance formula, we have to find all these values. So, A2 minus A1 is just subtract these two, you get this. And B1 cross B2 is what? This value. We are placing these B1, B2 value here, we just found out. So, this is B1 cross B2. when you take the dot product of b1 cross b2 with this one, we just have to do the multiplication of corresponding terms and add. The shortest distance will be, as we have found out the value, just place it in this formula, you get 98/7. So this is the part D, and also we have seen the total sample question paper of board 12th maths. Thank you so much.